Oh man, and there goes the mic muted. Fuck. Damn it. I forgot to do it. Son of a bitch. I was saying like that yeah, I don't think I was saying anything interesting at all. I think I was saying that Walter and Dottie are gonna be left alone in that house for a while. They're gonna get some go fish on. And it's gonna be, we're gonna miss out. Like, oh man. Seriously. And, what the hell else? Also that Walter had an earpiece. But like, Dottie could hear us, for sure. Like, no problem. I think there was something else. Didn't he say, Napoleon say that, like, he needed a million people to, like, get through the turnstile before the giant dog was wound? Or did he say 500? Because I thought he said a million people. And, like, 500 is fucking nowhere close. Oh, well. I have no idea, Ryan. Yeah, I think so, Miles. I think so. He said 500. Really? All right. Now we gotta input the code somewhere. In the dog's inner workings, right? The hell's this place? Yeah, that's like the serious amount of evil for sure.
Is this Plant World?
Correct, my dear. I am Madam Ladybug, the slightly irritated owner of Plant World. Instead of the beauteous red rose I ordered, I have been sent a mutant Venus flytrap by Napoleon LaRoche.
Nice cage, though.
A locked cage for which I have no combination. On top of it all, this particular Venus flytrap has something in its mouth.
Interesting. It's the off switch. How diabolical of a roach to feed it to a mutant Venus flytrap. I've gotta get it out of there and find a rose for the ladybug. No small feat. It's some kind of combination lock for this display cage.
Oh, and they're just like shapes. Alright, we'll get back to this to release the mutant flytrap.
Ooh, a magnifying glass.
Yes, I use it to get close up on the leaves and petals of all my lovely plants.
Right, I get it.
So, you really want a rose that bad, hmm?
What's the good of a flytrap, my dear, if it refuses to open its trap to trap flies? I want a rose in its place.
Did you ask it? Maybe it's just shy.
Well, for one thing, I don't speak Venus.
I don't speak Venus, she says. Wow. That's pretty intense. Yeah, normal Saturday night here. But yeah, Sunday night, I suppose. Wow.
I'd better answer my spy watch.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, an informant has a hot tip about the off switch and is waiting for you at the Food of the Future exhibit. Ask for the candy apple.
The candy apple. Got it. Thanks.
Monkey Penny signing off.
Spy Fox out.
No, Joseph, nothing. Food of the Future exhibit. Got it.
So that's my contact, eh? Brilliant disguise. I'd like a candied apple, please.
Certainly, sir. Here at Food of the Future, all food is on sticks. It allows you to enjoy your favorite foods without using a knife or fork or having to stop what you're doing. Here you go, a free candied apple on a stick sample.
Well, I have the candied apple.
Isn't that just grand?
Yes, but I, meaning me, have in my possession the candied apple.
Only one candied apple sample per customer. Now run along and enjoy the fair, Pumpkin.
Maybe she wants me to come back when there are less people around. Oh well, this candied apple looks good.
Watch what you're doing. You want to give me a coronary?
Ah, Lenny, you're the apple of my eye. What information do you have for me?
Hi, Spy Fox, listen close. There are spies everywhere, so don't look directly at me. This leaf contains the information that you need.
This is too small to read.
What do you want from me? I wrote it with my teeth. Now I've got to split. People are starting to stare. Throw me in the dumpster.
Suit yourself.
It's a perfectly good candied apple.
All right, save yourself.
All right. So, the food of the future, apparently, is everything's on a stick. Knives and forks are for barbarians. I get it. I understand, yeah. Wow, I am numb. Holy shit. I mean, she's a bug, so... So don't yell the word spy! Don't say it out loud! Anyone could be listening. Anyone. Aw, the fun button is the best button. We play Things in Space. It's a pretty good game.
That's not going to do-
Oh yeah, alright.
That won't do me. The flytrap is locked in this display cage by this rather interesting lock.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's dead too. Like, rip in peace, what was his name? Larry? Triangle, square triangle?
It's the leaf. This lock seems simple. I believe I could open it if I had the right combination.
I do, Kyra. There are plenty of people awake in the house right now. Maybe I have to, like, back up?
I've opened harder locks than this. With the right combination, this would be a cinch.
Was it a square? What?
It's the leaf from Lenny, the informant.
Yeah, what the... Oh! Oh! I put it under the magnifying glass to see.
I can see a star, a circle, and a triangle on this leaf.
Star, circle, triangle. I get it.
With the right combination, this lock would be a snap. I did it!
Hell yeah!
I'll have to figure out a way to get that flytrap and make it spit out the off switch.
It needs a rose. And we know where to get roses now. Yeah, Orion, I got it. Don't worry. I'll figure it out eventually. If you knew what to do without having to look for the codes, probably not. No. Probably not. What the hell's in this building? Whoa. Get it? Because DNA cloned and then that sheep got cloned, probably like when this game was made. Food cloning though. Gotcha. Right. Apple plus DNA equals two apples.
Welcome to you clone it where you get two for the price of one. Bah.
Stereo sheep.
I'm Doll and I'm Lee.
Hello, darling. So nice to have you back where you belong.
Lone Wolf. Hi. Hope you're doing great. Right? Yeah, I guess so. So we can clone food with this. Okay, good to know this is here. Stereo sheep, yeah, sheep in stereo. Stereo sound. Wow, it's a hell of a display. Aw, the amazing Cape Cod looks really sad.
Something seems fishy. Cod, bear your soul.
Oh, I'm sadder than an ant in a neck brace at a picnic. In the old days, it never failed. The Cape Cod would razzle and dazzle with his mighty cape of joy, and then the finale. A shot out of the cannon.
Sounds exciting.
Then, one fateful day, we were at a sea monkey convention, and my assistants Goldie and Blow were setting up my act. My lucky clear goggles were misplaced, and in their stead was a pair of dark goggles.
So what you're saying is that you need your lucky clear goggles?
You ever try to steer yourself with dark goggles after you've been shot out of a cannon, son?
Not lately, no.
Well, it's impossible to see the target.
How about lending me your dark goggles?
Since I don't have my lucky clear goggles, I need something to wear for my act. Even though these ones are so dark, I keep missing the target.
I need his dark goggles for some reason.
Here's...
I bet there's like a spy gadget I can...
It says the amazing Caped Cod.
Whoa. Quite the observation.
What's this? It looks like a pair of binoculars. Whatever that thing is, it's letting that bad guy type with the glasses on into the evil dogbot's Achilles heel. It looks like some kind of breath analyzer. There's too much of a rose tint on that screen to make out what breath it's showing.
Oh, so if I look...
That breath analyzer is letting that bad guy type with the glasses on into the evil dogbot's Achilles heel. I still can't see what breath is shown on screen. There's too much of a rose tint on that screen to see anything.
So, like, I need his dark goggles to see past the rose tint. Is that what it is? Okay. Yeah, he's a bad guy. Well, I mean, he knows that he's a bad guy because he got into the Achilles heel. I would think more than the black suit. Rose breath? It's possible. It's possible. Let's go back to Quack and see what goggles we can see. Actually, we haven't checked out this way yet, although I couldn't imagine this. Oh, this is the way to get to the heel. I see. We need rose glasses. See. Oh shit!
That bad guy put on those glasses, breathed on that breath device, and the secret door opened. That must be the secret door LaRoche mentioned that leads to the inner workings of the evil dogbot. I need to figure out how to get in there.
Yeah, I was gonna think it was like, why are all these birds suddenly like showing up, man? I don't understand. I was worried.
These rose-tinted glasses might come in handy.
Let's give them a try. Look at the screen, bro.
I wasn't fast enough. I need to get a better vantage point over that bad guy's shoulder.
I see. Now that I have the glasses,
wearing these rose-colored glasses all over the fair will give me a headache.
Oh, come on. All right, I get it. I understand.